Do you want to create an amazing underwater environment in Blender? This scene is a good example to show you how to make realistic water and breathtaking tropical paradise. But first, I would split this artwork into two parts. Everything is above water and underwater, and we will be working on this artwork with this meaning. If the first one is obvious, but the underwater, we have to talk in some details. I created this landscape using the landscape add-on in Blender. Simply scale it to create a larger surface. Using the sculpting tool, I marked the location for some islands, especially in the corner and on the opposite side. So, this is the main advice: do not do too much, especially at the beginning. It's better to add some details if it's necessary closer to the final stage of the work. Concentrate on the general and build your working process from the general to the details. For instance, I already know that some part of the background will be covered by waves and I will not need a lot of invisible details there. But in the beginning, it's difficult to predict everything where the creative impulse will bring us. So do not rush to throw too many details, leave it on the final stage. So I suggest not wasting a lot of time here and moving on to the water, because the water is the more interesting part there. There is a lot of information to cover here. First, we need to create an ocean surface, and for this, Blender already has an amazing ocean modifier that is capable of creating an ocean in one click. Using the time parameter here, we can animate waves, but I'm going to use time just to find some interesting wave shapes. As you can see, the camera is already placed so that the wave cuts the frame when the wave rolls out. I will find the better position, but now just make some changes to the ocean modifier. I have to increase the resolution to see more details on the water in the viewport and render. Maybe play with the random seed to find a wave. There are separate settings available for this. And this is exactly what I need, because there is where I can make these waves. Very high waves will not work, because it's going to be still clear weather, not a storm. I'm going to leave it somewhere here. I also want to increase repeat X and Y to get a larger plane of water, and now I can just move this object to find the beautiful line like that. So my goal is to find such an interesting waveform to split the frame into two parts with two plots. It should be one main plot for everything, but also separately makes sense. Let's enable preview render and think about how to create this water material. I add a new material and delete this principal material, because we need a glass shader, transparent, and mix shader to combine these two shaders. Also, we need light path and use shadows as a factor for mix shader. Basically, it looks like glass. And in fact, it's glass. Usually, this combination is used for glass in Blender. So, we have to change the shader a little bit to get water. First, I will change the color so that it's closer to the color of the sea water. Some kind of like this. Second, add a noise texture for the bump. Despite of we have details from the ocean modifier, I would rather prefer to add more small details to this material using a small value of bump. Just not too much. But it still doesn't look like real water, because water has density, like here. Further from the camera, denser and darker water we see. How do we achieve this effect, considering that we only have a water surface? I'll add sand texture to the ground for now, because the simple color is a little bit frustrating me, and return to the water material to make it more real. To achieve this, I can add principal volume and connect it with volume. Additionally, I need a volume absorption and add shader to combine these two volumes. Now everything looks like working with volume fog. I can change the density of volume and change color to some closer to the bluish sea, or even increase emission. but the magic in this volume absorption knot. Density value also will work on the density of the water, but color brings this amazing deep color like we need, and now this water doesn't look like a glass. Depending on the weather condition, we also have to change color or density to achieve different results. Now let's take a look at this photo. Here you can see that the surface of the water itself has thickness, but our water is pretty sharp. We need to fix this to get a realistic picture. To achieve the same effect, I'll just duplicate the ocean surface and add solidify modifier. As you can see, this added thickness, but the depth in the ocean disappeared. Since I have two surfaces, I can just slightly raise the one that has thickness and leave the first one. Maybe too much thickness, so I decrease solidify value. That already seems good, but still quite sharp, because our camera crosses the water, and as we remember from my previous video about realism in Blender, the closer the object into the camera, the more out of focus it will be. You may watch the video by the link in the corner if you missed. In short, under such circumstances, this water line should be right next on the camera lens, so that I enable depth of field in the camera settings. I will choose the ship as the focus object and use f-stop with 9 points. So now this line of the water is quite blurry, as it would be in the real situation if you could shoot a similar scenario with a real camera. Also, the softness and depth of field in the artwork turns the render into cinematic. But it still looks pretty sad. If we look at the photos, we can see such a caustic effect on the water. We can create this using texture light in Blender. To do this, I need just a spotlight. I will place it here that it highlights this part of the ocean sand. To use texture light, I need to enable use knot in the shader editor. Additionally, to create the caustic effect, I need the Voronoi texture, add mapping and use UV texture coordinate. But still nothing happens, though we may see some noise from this light here, and if I change the size, some noise effect is also noticeable. I can add a color ramp and change linear to B-spline. And now, using the color ramp and scale of the Voronoi texture, I can achieve the fake caustic effect, which will be formed by light that passing through this texture. Also, it brings some light rays because water material has volume settings as we remember. Maybe I do a copy of this texture light to place this one closer to the camera to get more light and sun rays underwater. Alright, using GeoScatter, I added some details to the ocean bottom like plants, small and large rocks. As I often say in my video, realism is achieved through details. Absolutely empty bottom of the ocean in this case looks rather sad. But the additional variety details such as grass, stones and shells turns this bottom into very realistic environment. Also, this light reflects quite coolly and add life to the render, turning into atmospheric picture. But I want to talk about another small details that probably no one will notice, but we need to add it. Many photo examples show that when the wave roll out, such bubbles also stretch behind it. I think it will be cool to add this such details as well. In order to reproduce this, first I need a helper object that will repeat the waveform and sphere to these bubbles. This object will be an emitter for the particle system, and I need to select this sphere as a particle object in the render settings of this particle system. So we see that these bubbles appeared, but we need to make them a little larger and add randomness scale, so that they have a different size and look more realistic. Next, I will reduce gravity, because I don't need them to fly at all, but to be closer to the surface of the water. And I want they do not fly over the surface of the water, but remains underwater. To do this, I will add collision to this ocean surface. It means when particles contact the surface, they will not continue to move above it. And they also add turbulence force to add variety to the direction of the movements of these particles. The wave must create movements and bubbles should be more dynamic in this case. Finally, we need to add material to these bubbles. I'll just take the existing water materials, just make a copy, because in this case of bubbles I don't need volume. Since I don't need further simulation of particles, I make instance real and move all these bubbles to the new collection and hide the particle emitter. Maybe I will make some changes to this particle. So, what we have on the render? Yeah, now it looks really cool. These bubbles also create additional details, so it looks good as for me. To complete the work, I will go to Compositing in Blender to make some adjustments. I definitely want to add some gaze to this horizon using depth pass and map range. This allows me to control the depth of the artwork in post-production. I talked in detail about this method and how it can be used. Link to this video is always in the corner. Next, I want to divide this picture into two parts with masks for everything underwater and above. This is because I can adjust these two parts separately using color correction and other nodes due to the underwater part can be a little bit darker and contrasting. Instead, the above part might have some fresh air. So with masks it's easy to do and work on each part separately. In general, I advise not to neglect post-processing. Only some scenes can be achieved in 3D scene and it's not necessary to do everything in 3D. Blender has its own building pipeline, from 3D scene to compositing and even video editing. Unfortunately, there are no powerful tools for color grading, but we can bring the work to the finished picture in compositing using color correction and other correction nodes. Don't forget that you can always download this and other scenes from my Patreon and understand the details. By the way, if you want to pump your skills in 3D and learn how to create similar cinematic artwork using free tools, I have a masterclass for you where I show you all the processing of creating cinematic animation from the beginning to the stunning result step by step. Link in the description. And so, for those who watch this video to the end, I have a small life hack. You can get access to all of my masterclass on Patreon by subscribing to Masterclass Tire at a lower price. Also subscribe to my channel because I see in analytics that a lot of you watching video without subscription. So, create amazing art, share it with the world, and see you in the next video.